Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Dr. Snehal Santosh Rathi. My topic for paper presentation is prenatal ultrasound evaluation of tetralogy of Fallot. Aims: to emphasize the ultrasound findings of tetralogy of Fallot, early detection of tetralogy of Fallot, evaluation of other associated pathologies and congenital defects in fetus by ultrasound. Introduction: TOF is a congenital heart defect, classically described like a 4 anatomical heart abnormalities. It is most frequent cyanotic heart defect and the most common cause of blue baby syndrome due to right to left shunt. Tetralogy of Fallot has 4 classic features: VSD, an overriding outer, pulmonary artery stenosis, and right ventricular hypertrophy. The VSD associated with tetralogy of Fallot is usually subaortic and is due to overriding of aorta. TOF is caused by unequal division of the conus resulting from anterior displacement of the truncoconal system. Prevalence of tetralogy of Fallot is 3-7% of congenital heart defects. The main reason for suspecting TOF is failure to demonstrate the normal crossing of great vessels at the base of the heart. Methods: retrospective study was conducted at a ANC OPD in a mother and child care hospital within a span of 6 months. Out of 15 cases suspected for congenital cardiac anomalies, 10 cases of TOF were recognized by ultrasound between 20 to 28 weeks of gestation. GE Logic P5 ultrasound machine was used. Strict adherence to PCPNET guidelines and proper written consent was ensured. In each case, a 4-chamber view to assess abnormalities of atria and ventricles and a base view to demonstrate crossing of great vessels were performed. Results: out of 15 cases suspected for congenital cardiac anomalies, 10 cases of tetralogy of Fallot were recognized by ultrasound between 20 to 28 weeks of gestation. Based on this small series, prenatal sonographic findings suggestive of TOF may be summarized as follow: a large aortic root, which is the most common prenatal sonographic finding, a small pulmonary artery or stenosis of the right ventricular outflow tract, a ventricular septal defect in the outlet portion of the septum, an overriding outer, which is best seen in the long axis view, and a right ventricular hypertrophy. The most common characteristic were ventricular septal defect and a large aortic root. Other associated findings like hydrops fetalis and polyhydramnios were also detected in 3 cases. Discussion: TOF is due to an embryological development of the heart in which an unequal conotruncal division results in a small pulmonary artery and a great aortic artery. The incomplete embryologic rotational process of the conotruncal septum explains the lack of alignment of the septum with the interventricular septum in tetralogy of Fallot. The incomplete rotational process of the aortic artery explains its juxtaposition, its overriding location above the interventricular septum, and its relationship with the right ventricle. The pulmonary artery remains in an anterior position in relation to the aorta. Now, this differentiates TOF from complete transposition of the great vessels, where the position of the pulmonary and aortic arteries is inverted. Under normal circumstances, one septum is continuous with the other. The abnormal alignment process produces a defect of tissue between the septa, causing the interventricular communication. On ultrasound examination, a perimembranous VSD is noted. Mildly stenotic right ventricular outflow tract is noted. Right ventricular hypertrophy is not noted in the mid-second trimester, but it develops after birth. Inverse relationship between the size of the ascending outer and pulmonary artery. A large aortic root is an important diagnostic clue. Color Doppler may demonstrate reverse flow in the ductus arteriosus to the main pulmonary artery. In pulmonary stenosis and atresia, high velocity and turbulence is noted. Doppler studies demonstrate increased peak velocities in the pulmonary artery due to the right ventricular outflow tract obstruction. It may also demonstrate no flow in the pulmonary artery if complete atresia is present. The overriding of aorta with blood entering from both ventricles into the aorta is visible in the form of Y-shaped image in color Doppler during systolic phase. Other findings such as hydrops fetalis or polyhydramnios may also be helpful, especially in the case of dysplastic pulmonary valves. In the following images, in the first image, there is a VSD with a large aortic root. In the second and the third image, there is mildly stenotic right ventricular outflow tract with high velocity and turbulence noted. In the fourth image, there is a VSD with overriding of aorta. And in the fifth image, in the three vessel view, only two vessels are seen. Narrow pulmonary artery is noted. Conclusion. The TOF is the most common congenital cyanotic heart disease. The antenatal diagnosis can lead to look for other associated abnormalities or chromosomal aberrations and allow us to determine a therapeutic strategy. Thank you.